Okay. Oop, let me make sure that. All right, that's good. Okay. Megovanen, everyone, and welcome to a character creation, video. It is October 24, 2024, and tomorrow, you know, this Friday, I'm going to be playing some tabletop Dungeons and Dragons with my good friend Scott from Slice of Scott. His channel I'm gonna put in the description down below, so you can go ahead and click on his name and it's going to take you to his channel. He's going to be the dungeon master, and there's only going to be it's a solo adventure with just him and I tried, you know, to get other people. I even put a post, but no one seemed to be interested in it, except there was one guy, but he's a good friend, but I should have checked, but I know who he is, but I won't say. But basically he was concerned, I forgot the words he used, but exactly how he put it, but something to the effect that maybe is maybe a little bit abnormal or something like that. But I feel as if there's no need to be concerned. You know, if someone like me can, you know, come online and show myself and make videos and stuff, then really anyone can do it. So, and we're all good people. You know, I don't think anyone bad watches my channel. We're all gamers, and you know, we all have good fun. So there was really no concern for that. But of course I respect that, you know, if for whatever reason. But I just wanted to put your mind at ease that if that was your concern, then that need not, you know, weigh heavy on your mind, because, you know, we're all good people. We're not racist or prejudiced or anything like that. We're all good people. So I just wanted to bring that up just in case there is a next time. Okay, so it will be, you know, pen and paper and with a dice. I don't know where my physical dice are, and I don't want to take the time to look for them, but I have a dice roller thing here, a program, and I'm just going to use that. Okay, so first I want to thank you, Scott, for, you know, taking the time to be a DM for this campaign. And again, sorry that I wasn't able to find other people, but you said, of course, it's no problem. You've done a solo game in the past before. Oh, I better. My nighttime heart medicine. I take medicine in the day. It's for my heart and blood pressure. And I'm going to take one now. But thank you again, Scott. Thank you so much for that. You know, sometimes I forget to take my medicine. Okay, so I think last I remember when I played, this was over 20 years ago. No, last time I played, actually, it follows the rules from when I started. This was maybe about 20, 25 years ago. But last time I played was, I want to say, 2010, 2011, somewhere around there. I'm thinking more closer to 2010. But so it's been a while, but I think it was third edition. So I don't want to waste too much time, so let's go ahead and get started. Okay, I will make my character Falagar. Do I want to call myself Falagar the Wise or Falagar the Great? Why not? And I am a mage. Her name. Falagar. I will be human. And I am a wizard. I don't know what level we are starting at. Just for fun, let's start 5th level. I hope that's okay. My alignment will be chaotic good. Religion, we'll go with none. Right. I forgot what I have to roll up with this. Ah, okay, roll scores. Ah. Shall I try again? Oh, the last one didn't seem all that bad, but I'm able to get like an 18 out of this. Okay, 6. I would like to have high intelligence but also high dexterity so I can possibly roll or move first in combat. That's how I would always do it in something like a Bard's Tale or Might and Magic. You want to have a high dex, even Baldur's Gate 3. Wow, these are some shit rolls. Oh, okay, here we are. I mean, dexterity could be better, but yeah. I like that. I like that. Okay, we're gonna go with that. I hope this is recording okay. Select skills. Basic writing. Right. Sense motive. Oh. That's it. Okay. I don't know how many. Oh, okay. What? Okay. And my feet. Brew potion. Okay, I have one wizard feet. Well, combat casting, this is really important. I think it's something about being able to cast at point blank. I won't pick any equipment yet. I'll wait for, the start of the game. Ah, okay. Elven. Whoops. I cannot select that. Uncommon Sylvan, let's say Goblin. Ah, select spells. Magic missile. Mystic shield, mage armor. Featherfall. Jump. Spectral hand. Some of these I also remember from Eye of the Beholder, possibly even Baldur's Gate. So you have Fireball, so it's a level 3 spell. Okay. And this one, I think it affects a radius. If we're going by those rules, however, I don't know if it's possible to, you know, roll up a character using this 3.5, but play it kind of the modern way. They don't really use, you know, a board anymore. You know, everything is through wording. If you watch anything from Critical Role or when Deborah Ann Woll DMs, you know, something like that. So if you're watching this, Scott, is there a way that we could play it that way without the board? Play it like the modern way that, that they play it? I don't even know what. I've been so out of it for a long time that I don't, you know, I'm not sure what they call it. Okay. Vampiric touch. Fly. Did I pick levitate? I did not. Okay, I'll pick fly. Okay, I think I'm good with that. Extra notes. Save. Okay, let me pause this. Okay, so I guess this is it. You know, it does not list my spells, but it's okay. Yeah, it's all right. I'll just go back to the video and take snapshots of, or screenshots of that page, of those pages where it lists my spells and stuff and skills. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Looks like we're going to be playing this around 9 o'clock p.m. That's Chicago time. And that is it.